We have a faithful ruler, mighty Father, given in victory over the adversaries. May you align to be for them a weapon for peace and invisible standard, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. On us and our faithful protector, do not spare our supplication. Gracious and all praise that bubbles on all the Orthodox commonwealth. Preserve those who are called to God and grant them victory from on high. For you, the only blessed one, give glory to God. Thank you. You might have put a burden upon me before you know so me. You took my friends away from me, you made me know some truth. I was close to them and could not escape, my eyes were being with distress. I cried out to you, O Lord, all the day I stretched out my hands to you. But will you grow wonders for the dead? Or can physicians bring them up to sing you praise? Does anyone see you love in the grave of Jesus in the midst of protection? Are you marvelous and anomaly of darkness from justice in the land of obedience? And yet, O Lord, I cried out to you, my prayer shall rise and dawn. Why, O Lord, do you reject my prayer? Why do you hide the face away from me? I pray the trouble since my youth, I was raised high and humble in his presence. He placed his sword over me and tears it left me shaking. They surround me like waters all the day, and closed in upon me from all sides. You have distanced me from friends and enemies, and my family is so right of mine. O Lord, God of my salvation, day and night, I cry out before you. If my prayer reach up to you, and be to my request, O Lord. Bless the Lord of my soul, may all things bless his holy name. Bless the Lord of my soul, and forget not all the gifts from me, the parts of the sins, and heals me from the grave. Who brings into life of corruption, the Lord with love and mercy. Who fills you wrong as much good in you, teach me new blood details. The Lord informed me to the kindness of dedication to all the oppressed. Is made known as grace to Moses and his will to his many children. The Lord is the one of compassion and mercy, long suffering and manifold love. His condense is not forever, but his anger always lasts. He has not dealt with us as our sins demand, or does he bear our evil deeds. For as high as the heavens stand over the earth, so far as the Lord extends his love for those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed our sins from us. As kind as the fathers to the children, so is the Lord to those who fear him. For he himself knows well what we perform, remember we are all a man of dust. In man these days resembles grass as a flower of the field, so shall he grow. But that at least my soul for him and his God, and never shall know his place again. But the love of the Lord is from all eternity to all eternity for those who fear him. And he justice upon the children of those who keep his conduct and remembers who also obey him. For the Lord establishes his throne in heaven, over all things his kingdom is supreme. Bless the Lord, his angels, who strong and mighty ones who obey his word and hear the sound of his decree. Bless the Lord, his fathers, the tenants who obey his will. Bless the Lord, his words in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord of my soul. Bless the Lord of my soul in every place of his dominion. O Lord, hear my prayer and truth and give heed to my plea and invite his answer. And enter not into judgment with his servant, since all the living is thus just in your son. The enemy has hunted me down and has crushed my life to the ground. He has forced me to live in darkness like those who are dead. My spirit faces grief, and within me my heart is in despair. I recall the days of old, and meditate on all your deeds, I promise the works of your hands. I stretch out my hands to you like a parched hand, my soul thirsts for you. Make haste to answer me, O Lord, my spirit is failing. Turn not your face away from me, as I feel like those in the pit. Grant that I may hear you step up this love and throne, for I have placed my hope in you. O Lord, teach me the way I should go, for I lift out my soul to you. O Lord, deliver me from my enemies, it is you that I have fled. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. May evil spirits keep me on a straight path for the sake of the name of the Lord, who will keep me alive. With your righteousness, you deliver me from affliction. With your love and kindness, you will destroy my enemies. And bring to all those who oppose and cry, I am your servant. O Lord, hear my prayer and truth and heed to my pain and righteous answer. May evil spirits keep me on a straight path. Those of the day on the young man, the day of the day, and they shall honor my honor, amen. Alleluia, 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 those who bows. Alleluia, 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 the glory to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 those of the young man, the day of the day, and they shall honor my honor.
Υπέρ του Ασίας αεροφορίας με καρπόνι Thank you. Upon them, and they said nothing to anyone. Oh. Thank you. Tyrant's cruelty. Thank you. Είπε δε αυτό Ιησούς, είπε λέγει σαν αυτό. He wants us to be cleansed often. to ask for and to receive healing. The holidays are for our healing. Christmas, the Nativity of our Lord, God's holy incarnation. The Son, one of the Holy Trinity, took flesh and was born of a virgin. Think about it. What is the significance of celebrating Christmas, Christ's birth, every year? We celebrate with trees, Santa Claus, gifts. What is the deeper meaning our Lord is trying to communicate to us through the church cycle of holidays, year after year after year, for 2023 years? It is for our healing. Remember the young man's question, "Good teacher, what shall I do to inherit eternal life?" Follow the commandments, and then sell all that you own and follow me. Celebrating Christmas, Easter, and every feast of the church is part of following Jesus. It is part of our living by his commandments. Christos genate doxasate, Christ is born, glorify him, we say. He is not being born now, December 25th, 2022, nor is he being born in our imagination. He is born spiritually and metaphysically in our hearts as we draw near to him, as we make a home for him to enter our hearts. He was already born and already saved us. This is why at the crucifixion he said, "Tetelestai," it is finished. We are asking him in as he knocks. We are asking for transformation and transcendence. The holidays are not merely a message from God. They're a reminder that he gave us salvation. Eternity in the kingdom of heaven was gifted to us. As frail people, we forget. We lose focus. The church is the star which guides us to the Sun of Righteousness with feasts and holidays, with preparations around the holidays to make ready not only our homes with decorations, but our hearts, our spirits. This is the message of this holiday and every holiday. This is why we fast, why we prepare, to get ready to receive our Lord year after year, every day, and to follow him. Selling all that we own and following Jesus is not for everyone. Few follow this calling literally. This is the monastic tradition of our faith, the ascetical life. However, we can all confess our sins and change our ways. We can all turn to God more often, to strive to let go and keep letting go of what holds our spirits back. Having money and treasure is not a sin. It is a tool that can be used for good. We, as stewards, support this and all his churches with our treasure. The world is fed by the treasure of many. By the stewardship of the resources God has given us, greed and consumption are the pitfalls, and Jesus can help us be free of them. The holiday cycle of the year is about repetition. Thanking God over and over is a discipline. It's a practice. It's what we call in Greek askesis. We are human beings and we are easily distracted, and the church exists to guide us in the ways of God. So as we shop for gifts, trees, turkeys, decorations, make kuluraka, put on our bake sales and fundraisers, feed those in need, and do charitable works, let us remember that he is the reason for the season. Thousands of people convert to Orthodoxy because of how we Orthodox celebrate the holidays, especially Christmas and Easter, and especially in our worship services. The fullness of our communal celebrations are made manifest in our parish worship right here. Let us appreciate this as Orthodox Christians. The Lord has given us the gift of his only Son. He gave us the medicine of healing through his body and blood. Whoever partakes will have salvation. When we receive communion, we say, for the forgiveness of sins and for life everlasting. Amen. I pray that we partake in this wonderful invitation of our Lord to follow him, as he said in today's gospel. May we be inspired and given the strength to overcome the difficulties of our lives, remembering what is impossible with men is possible with God. Amen.
Thank you.
I love you, Lord, my strength. The Lord is my foundation, my refuge.
The Lord's, the Lord's in wisdom, let us be attentive.
Istemi sen theon patera pratra, e kiura nuke isto tonte che pan diorato, e sen a kiura misu Christon, ai ondu te udu morgeni, per tu patro che ni tenda con pan con tu leon. Forse fotos te omeni di non, e te uomini di nu, che ni tenda tutti di tenda con usio di patrini di papanna e genu. Το δημάσου σου τρόπου και την μητέρα σωτηρία, κατά πρώτα εκ του ουρανών και σαν το τέντρα εκ νέμα της Αγίου και Μαρία της Παρθένου και Ανθρωπίσατα. Στα ουρανέντα τα υπερημών, τα καρδίου πιλάτου και τα φόντα και τα φέρα. Και να στάθω την τρίτη μέρα και τα γραφάς. Και να βγόνται στους ουρανούς και καθεζόμενα εξιών του Πατρός. Και πάλι ερχόμενα με τα δόξης, κρίνες όντας και νεκρούς, που και στα σωτήρας, που και σε τέλος. Και στο πνεύμα του Άγιου, το Κύριο, το Σοφιό, και του Πατρός εκπορευόμενα, το Σύμπατρή και η Όρθος προσκυνούμενα και συνοξαζόμενα τον Αλίσσα διά των προφητών. Εις μία Αγία Καθολική και Αποστολική Εκκλησία, ομολογών βάπτισμα εις άφηση των Αγιών, προσδοκώ Ανάσταση νεκρών και ζωή του μέλλοντος αιώνους. Αμήν.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets, in one holy and active and apostolic church, I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Let us stand aright, let us stand in awe, let us be attentive. That we may present the holy offering in peace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Let us Thank you.
che mi sanelli si passi per osmo, alla risse mas fatto con Dio. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
servant of God, host on the most received by the blood of Christ, forgive us of sins and for life eternal.
Sos hombres.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God of spirits and of all flesh, you trample upon death the boss and power of the devil, giving life to your world. Give rest to the soul of your departed servant, George, in a place of light, in a place of green pasture, in a place of refreshment, where from pain, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. As a good and loving God, forgive every sin he has committed in word, deed, or thought. For there is no one who lives and does not sin. You alone are without sin, and your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and your word is truth. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Hola. We hope everyone's Thanksgiving was a blessed one. I wanted to just offer a few welcomes and a few wishes before I get to my announcements. Hola to Steve, who celebrates.
celebrated yesterday, St. Stylianos. We also have the icon of St. Stylianos as well as St. Catherine. Bring it to Presbytera, of course, we celebrate on Friday. Anna, we have liturgy for St. Anna this year, by the way, FYI, coming up in a few days. And we have an icon of St. Anne as well. I'd like to welcome John. Mr. John is in the back row. He wanted to experience Orthodoxy through our worship today. Please, if you can, stay for coffee hour. I would like to get to know you. So many people I'd like to welcome. Nicolette, good to see you. You're here, church Sunday morning. I don't know what you college kids do on Saturday nights, but you made it here today. God bless. Good job. Pray also for the Andrews that are going to celebrate on Wednesday. And I'm sure I'm missing something. Mr. Sam, Kiri Andonia, good to meet you. Andonia, and good to have you today. Very nice to see you. I think that's it for my surprises. Okay, we have a Vasilopita sale. Please see Presbytera to order a Vasilopita. This is a fundraiser that will help the Greek school, and the last day to order yours is December 5th. They'll be arriving for December 18th for the Christmas pageant, which will also be a fundraiser bake sale that day for the Greek school. And we invite everyone to stay for the Christmas pageant, to support our children, our families, and the whole Greek school. Tomorrow, Monday evening, we have Parakleses at 5:30, and 6:30 we have book club and Bible study. Wednesday, we have liturgy for St. Andrew, 8:30 to about 11 to 10:30. Friday, we have December 2nd. This Friday, we have our tree lighting at 7 p.m. Our youth is also collecting, doing a couple of charitable collections in the Hellenic Center. You can see Anna or Lucy if you have any questions. Anna, raise your hand. There you go. They're collecting items for things of my very own, and they're in need of twin and full-size bedding sheets, personal hygiene supplies like hairbrushes, brand new clothing for boys and girls, especially in children's sizes, 12 to 20, brand new bath towels. And all the details are posted up there, and you can also see on if you have any questions. Next Sunday, December 4th, we have Stewardship Sunday. It's a reminder also, if you haven't pledged or fulfilled your pledge for 2022, to be members of our church in 2022, please do so. We have pledge forms in the back. They look like this. And if you have any questions, you can speak to any one of us, myself, any one of the parish council members, or Lucy Brady or Tony Cananis. Lucy, wave your hand. And you'll help us kick off the 2023 campaign by coming next Sunday, Stewardship Sunday, and we have a lunch that we will also serve during our presentation. December 10th, we have a church fundraiser, Christmas Boutique, 10 to 3 p.m., and there will be various booths and crafts, lunch, and Greek pastries to purchase, and that is a fundraiser for the church, Friday, December 16th. So in our bulletins, you'll see everything written, but I'm just pointing out some very special events and services. On Friday, December 16th, we will have an evening vigil, an agrimnia. This is a Vesper service, Apoklesia Orthos and Divine Liturgy, in the evening, 8 p.m. to 1 a.m. That's why it's called the vigil. You kind of stay up. We're not staying up too long, but you stay up through the night. And we chant special hymns for St. Dionysios of Zagynthos and the three holy youths. Besides being beautiful saints that we want to celebrate, it's also a nice opportunity within the Lent, within the Advent fast, that we can have an agrikmia, something a little more spiritual, and a service that we really don't do many times in this church. And in many parishes, they don't do these services. So it's a nice opportunity if you want to come and worship with us. It'll be special. December 18th, we will have our Christmas pageant, like I said. And save the date, also January 8th, in celebration of Epiphany, the Theophania, we will be blessing the waters of the Mohawk River behind the casino on the harbor after Divine Liturgy and coffee hour. So that will be exciting. We've been trying to do it ever since I came, but because of COVID, because of ice or rain, we've had to cancel these last couple of years, so hopefully we'll get it done this year and have extra blessings for Schenectady. The Christmas schedule, the service schedule is in the back. If you haven't gotten it, I believe that's all.
Father?
Yes?
Christmas card for the parish
is missing. Is the deadline today? Okay, next week is the deadline to join our community Christmas card. Please see Zanetta or Lucy. They'll help you out to get your family's names in the card. God bless you all, and please come forward for the Adidoro blessing and for coffee hour. Gracias.